Let me first wish all of you a very good day.
Computer Shiksha is supported by.
In the previous class, you learned about some of the options of the insert menu. You will learn something new today, but before that, let us revise the earlier class. Can you tell why we use manual break? With manual break, you can break your sheet into rows and columns as per your requirement. Do you know why we use cells? With the cells option, you can insert cells into the spreadsheet, meaning that you can bring up new cells. Can you tell why we use the sheet option? With the sheet option, you can insert many sheets. Can you tell why we use sheet from file option? You can insert any sheet from a saved file with the sheet from file option. Do you know why we use the chart option? Using the chart option, you can view the data of your sheet in a graphical form. Switch on your computer and open your Calci file. Have you opened the spreadsheet file or not? Let us now get to know what we will learn today. You will first make a table. After that, you will learn about some of the options of the format menu, like default formatting, cells, rows, columns, sheet, merge cells, page, print area, character, paragraph, change case, auto format, and conditional formatting. After that, you will revise some of the formulas that you learned in the earlier class, like if, and, or, count, and count blank. Now, make a new table or open a saved file. Let us now learn about the cell option of format. Let us learn about the number option of the cell option. With the number option, you can change the formatting of the numbers. You can convert standard numbers into decimals, percentages, and you could even apply a country's currency before the number. And you can also change the formatting of the date. With this video, let us learn more about using the number option of the cell option. With this video, we will now see how we can use the cell option of the format menu. So, to use the cell option by which you can change the format or the number style of the cell, we first need to select the cell that we want to apply this option on. So, we have selected this cell as shown in the video where 100 is written. Take your pointer to the format option, click on the cell option, and you see many options available here in the format cells box. Click on numbers option because we want to see what type of numbers we can apply. So there are various categories like number, percent, currency, date, time, scientific, fraction, etc. And also all or user defined. So there are many types of categories. If you want to use percentage, you can click on percent and then click on OK, and you will see that the percentage gets applied on the cell that you had selected. Once again, take your pointer to format option and click on cells. Let's now see what we can do with currency option. So click on currency, and you can see that there are many currencies available here. If you click on the drop down button, you will see currencies of many, many countries are shown here. You can scroll up and down and you can see European currencies. You can see all countries, the currencies are available here. So we have to select the currency that we want to show on the selected cell. As we are seeing here, we are scrolling up and down to look at different currencies. And let us look for the European Euro currency. So once we find that, we can click on that to select that currency. And then we click on OK. So you can see that the Euro sign comes in front of the 100. Once again, click on Format, click on Cell Option. This time, let's look for the variations of date. As soon as you click on date, there are many formats available and you can select the format which you like. You want the date first or you want the month first, so or you want it in numbers or in text. So there are various categories available. Click on OK after selecting and you see that a date gets applied on this cell. Once again, going to format, going to cell. Now we select the time category. And again in time, you see there are many different styles of time. Select one you like, click on OK. And you can see the time gets applied on the cell that you had selected. Once again, we are going to format. And this time we look at fonts. So there are different fonts that you can use for the text or the number which is in your selected cell. You can change the typeface, you can change the size. Choosing font effects, you can change the font color. Using alignment, you can select the various alignments, left, center, right, justified or filled. So you can change the alignment of the text or number in the cell that you have selected. If you choose the borders option, you can apply different borders like the one which is being shown in the video to you. You can even change the color of the border by clicking on the drop down window here, button here, and you can apply shadow by selecting one of these options. So cast shadow to the bottom right is what we have selected. And we can also arrange the border, whether we want it on all four sides or up and down or across. So we've selected all four sides. Now we click on OK and you can see that the border in that orange color gets applied and also a shadow is shown on our selected cell. Once again, let's go to Format, go to Cells. The next option here is the background option. With this, you can change the background color of the selected cell. So whichever color you select here gets applied as the background to the cell that you have selected. Click on OK and you will see the color changes there. So this way, you can use the cell option of the format menu and do various changes. Next, we will learn about the row option of the format menu. With the help of the row option of the format menu, you can hide any row or you can show the same. You can also increase or decrease the size of the same. Let us learn about the row option with the help of the video. In this video, let us now see what changes we can make using the row option of the format menu. So firstly, if you want to change in a row, first select that row, like we have selected the A row, bring your pointer to format and then click on the row option. Once you bring your pointer to row option, you can see there are options for height, so you can change the height of the row or make it optimal height or even hide and show the row. So if you want to change the height, click on height and you can see that you can change the height by clicking on the up arrow or the down arrow. So you can choose that. We have changed it a little bit and clicked on OK. And you can see that the height has now increased to 0.58 that we had selected in that box. So this row has increased in its height. Let's select the next row, the B row. Go to Format, go to the Row option, take the pointer there, and this time let's look at the Optimal Height option. If you use, when you click here, the box opens and you can add certain height to the existing height by clicking on up arrow. That much height will be added. So when we click OK, we see that this row has become very wide. The B row, the height has been added already. So if you want to bring it back, we select Format again, go to Rows, and now this time select Optimal Height and click on the default value. So we are selecting the default value. So when we click on OK, you will see that it becomes in its original size. If you want to change the A row also back to original, go to Format, go to Rows, and go to the Height option. And even here you have the default value option. So you can click there or select that, click on OK, and it will also become back to its original value, original width. Now once again, select the Format option. Select the Rows option from the Format menu and let's click on Hide. So as soon as you click on Hide, you will see that the row that you had selected, the A row, gets hidden from our sheet. So this is how you can change the row width and also hide or show it. If you want to show it, once again, take it to Format, click on Row, and click on Show. So the one which you had hidden, that row appears back again as is being shown in the video to you. So this is how you can use the row option of the Format menu. Next, we learn about the column option of Format. With the column option of Format menu, you can increase or decrease the size of any column and you can hide or show any of the columns also. With the help of the video, we will see how the column option of the Format menu is used. In this video, we are going to see what happens when we use the column option of the Format menu. So, whatever changes you want to bring to the column, first select that column. We have selected A, go to the Format option, click there and then click on the column option. You have width, optimal height, width, hide and show. So let's click on width. The box opens and you can increase or decrease the width from the up arrow or the down arrow. So we click on OK. And you can see that it has changed slightly. It has become 1 inch wide. So the width has changed. If you want to bring it back to its original size, we can select the column, take the pointer to the Format option, click on the column options, click on width again, and this time just select the default value. Click on OK. And you will see it comes back to its normal size. Once again, let's take a pointer to the Format option. Click on the Columns option. And this time, let's click on Optimal Width. Let's see what happens with Optimal Width. The box opens. With Optimal Width, the up arrow and the down arrow add certain amount to the width which is already there. So we are adding 0.7 inches and click on OK and it has become 0.7 inch instead of 1 inch. Once again, you want to bring it back to original size. Click on format, click on column, and click on optimal value, optimal column width. And this time we are selecting more. So we are selecting 3 inches. Click on OK. And you can see that the first column, A column, has become 3 inches wide. Now to bring it back, once again we take the pointer to format, click on column, and click on the optimal width option, and click on the default value, which is 0.1 inch. So you will see it becoming 0.1 inch wide. Click OK. It has just become very small. So if we want to bring it back to its original size, we once again click on the format option, click on column, and this time let's select the width option and select default value so that it will come back to its original size. Click on OK and you can see it comes back to its original size. Now you can also use the column option of the format menu to hide or show the column. Click on format, click on column, and click on the hide option. And you will see that the A column gets hidden from our sheet. You can see the A column is no longer there. Our sheet starts from B column, then C, D, E. So the A column has been hidden. If you want to bring it back or you want to show it, go to format again, go to column, click on the show option, and the column that you had hidden gets shown back in your sheet. So this way you can use the column option of the format menu to increase or decrease the width of the column and also to hide and show the columns. The next option of the format menu is that of the sheet. With the sheet option of the format menu, you can hide or show the sheet and can also rename your sheet. We will watch this video to learn about using the sheet option. In the next video, let us now learn about using the sheet option. Sheet option, you can make changes on your sheet that you are working on. So to use the sheet option, take your pointer to format, left click on it, and then bring your pointer to the sheet option. You see there are options for rename, hide, tab color highlighted. If you click on rename, you can change the name of your sheet. So backspace on the sheet name and then type, like we have typed computer shiksha. Click on OK and you will see in the tab below, instead of sheet 1, now computer shiksha name is written. So this way you can rename or give a new name to the sheet that you are working upon. Take the pointer once again to format menu, click there, click on the sheet option, and this time let's click on the hide option. So when you click on the hide option, this sheet that you were working on gets hidden from your Calci file. You can see only sheet 2 and sheet 3 are visible now. If you want to bring it back, take the pointer again to format, bring it to sheet option, and now you can see show option is also highlighted. Click on show and you will see that you see a box. It shows you all the sheets which are hidden. So select the sheet, computer shiksha, click on OK. And you will see that your computer shiksha sheet is now visible again or is again shown. Now, if you want to change the color of the tab where computer shiksha is written, if you want to change the color there, go to format menu, click on sheet option and click on tab color option. Once you click on the tab color option, a box opens and shows you many colors. So select the color that you like, and as soon as you select the color, click on OK. Once you click on OK, you will see that a line of that color has come on the tab that you were using. So this way you can use the sheet option to rename, hide or show the sheet and also change the tab color. Let us now learn about merge cell. Do you know why we use merge cell? With merge cell, you can merge more than one cell into a single cell. Watch the video to learn more about the merge cell. In this video, we are going to see how we use the merge cells option. So with merge cells, you can merge the contents of two or more cells into one. So you can make two or more cells as one cell. So let's first type something in this cell. Like in the video we have shown, we have typed A. And in the next cell, we have typed B. Now, if we take our pointer to the format menu and click there, you can see that the merge cell option is not highlighted. It will only get highlighted if we have first selected the cells that we want to merge. So come back to your sheet and select the cell A and where you have typed A and B. So once we have selected, take the pointer back to the format menu, left click on that, and now you can see merge cell option is highlighted. Click on that. A box appears which says, should the contents of the hidden cell be moved into the first cell? So if we say yes, the B of the right cell also gets moved into the first cell. So A, B is written together and these two cells have become one cell, one large cell. Now if you take the pointer again to format and click on merge cell, again, you will see that the two cells appear as normal, but the contents have already been merged. So this way, you can have contents of two cells merged together. Now, if we write C in the second cell and select these two cells, we can again perform a merge cell operation. Click on merge cells. Again, it is asking you, should the contents be moved to the left cell? This time let's click on no. So what will happen is the second cell gets hidden and only the first merge cell where AB is written is shown. If you want to merge the contents of the cell which has C written in it also into the AB cell, then we need to do a merge cell operation again. So we select these cells, both the cells where AB and C is written. Take the pointer to format and then click on merge cell and say yes. And you can see that a merge cell has been made and A, B, C are now together. So this way you can use the merge cell option. Next option is of page. With the page option, you can do many types of work on your document like page type, border, header and footer. You will learn more about these. With the help of this video, you will learn about using all of these options. We will now learn to use the various options of the page option. We can change the format of the paper, we can change the orientation and also the header and footer. So take your pointer to format menu, click on page and from the box that opens, click on the page tab. You can see the first option here is for paper format. So when you click on the drop down, you see many options available for the format. Options like A4, B5, A3, A6. So many options are available. Right now we have selected A6, so the paper format will change. We have clicked on OK, but you don't see the change here. To see the change, you have to go to the file menu, left click on that, and then click on the page preview. Once you click on the page preview, you will see that your page format has changed to the A6 style. When you print it, it will print in A6. Close the preview. Again, take your pointer to format. Select the page option. Click on that. The next option we see here in the page for format option, you can try to change it and see a different format. For instance, we are scrolling down and we have selected DL envelope style. Click on OK. Again, you can't see the change. To see the change on your sheet, you have to go to the file menu and select the page preview. As soon as you select the page preview, you will see that the envelope format has been applied to your page. Again, this will be shown when you print this page. So let's close the preview. Take the pointer again to the format menu. Left click on that and then click on the page option. From the box that opens, you see you can change the width and the height according to your requirement also. As soon as you start changing, the format changes to user defined. So you can change the width, you can increase or decrease the width and the height. So we are doing that. We have increased the width, we have increased the height. Click on OK and you will see the change once you go to page preview. You don't see the change on the sheet, but if you go to the file menu, click on page preview, you will see the change has happened. Close the preview. So the height and the width are according to what we had selected. Let's once again take the pointer to format and then select the page option, because there are many options that we can see. You can change the orientation. Right now it was in portrait. You can change it to landscape. In portrait, the height is bigger than the width, but in landscape, the width is larger and the height is smaller. Click on OK. And again, to see the change, we have to go to the file menu and click on page preview. So you can see now your sheet has become into the portrait format, into the landscape format. So the width is larger than the height. Once again, close the preview. Take the pointer to the format option. We are going to see some more options of the page option here. So once again, let's change it back to portrait and see the change applied on our page. Click on OK. Again, go to the file menu and click on page preview, just to show you how it changes. So this time it will be in portrait mode. As you can see in the video, the height is more and the width is less. Close the preview. Let's once again go to the format option. There are many options in the page submenu here, so we are trying to look at all of them. Now at the bottom you have margins. So when you set the margin or increase the margin, it increases the distance between the left side of the sheet till where the text is written. Click on OK. Once again, to see the change that we have made, we have to look at page preview. As you already know, we have to go to the file menu, left click there, click on page preview, and you can see here there is a gap between the left side of the page and the text that is written, the first column that is there. So this way we have increased the left margin. Close preview. Let's again go to format and see what happens with the other margins. click on page, come to the right margin. You can increase the right margin also. We have made it 1 inch, 1.35 inch. We clicked on OK. And again, by going to File menu, we are going to select the page preview to see what change has been applied. And you can see on the right side also, now there is a margin between the column and the last part of the page. So this way you can apply the margins. Close preview. You can also apply margins on top and bottom. So let's see that. Click on page after going to format menu. And you can see there are top margin, bottom margin. You can use these also to change the margin from the top and the bottom also. So we just close this. Now let us see what are the other options of the page submenu in the format menu. So you can change things like the background of your page. So we take a pointer to the format menu, left click on that, click on page, the page box opens. This time we are going to look at borders first. So click on the borders option and you can see that you can apply borders. And you can change the style of the border line and the color also. So there are many options here. You can apply borders on all sides or only left border or only right border or border on two sides. We have selected set border on all four sides and you can see that in the preview also. Now we are selecting the line type for the border. So we click on the one which we like. Next, we can also change the color of the border. So you click on the drop down window here or the drop down box and select the color that you want to apply on the border. So we have selected one of these colors. You can also apply shadow on the border. So there is a position, either it can be no shadow or cast shadow on the right side, left side, top or bottom. So you can select one of them. We are selecting one which is cast shadow to the bottom right. Then we can increase the distance of the shadow from this window as is being shown in the video and change the color. Click on the drop down box and look for the color that you want. This is for the shadow. Now click on OK. And all these changes will get applied on your sheet. However, it is not visible to you. For that, you have to go to the File menu, left click on that and look for Page Preview. So in the Page Preview, you can see the border has been applied, the shadow has been applied and the distance between the shadow is also there. Close the preview. Let's see what else we can do with the page submenu. Click on format, click on the page, and this time let's choose the background option. So click on the background option or the background tab, and you see many colors are available. So you can select one of the colors which you like so that the background color, it is shown in the preview. As soon as you click on OK, that will be applied. In fact, you can set the background as a color or even a graphic, a diagram also. But right now we want a color, so we just click on OK after selecting the color. Again, this does not show in the background of your sheet. But if you go to the page, if you go to the File menu, click there, click on Page Preview, you can see that the background color has got applied. When you print it, all these changes will be there on your sheet. Now, another few options which are available with the page submenu are of the header and footer. So we can also apply a header or a footer to our sheet. To do that, we will again take a pointer to the format option, format menu, left click on that, click on page, and this time let's select the header option. Click on the header tab. When you click here, you see that the header is already on. If it is not on, you should click on the header. And then if you click on the edit button, another box opens and it shows you that you can have left area, you can write something, center area and right area. For the header, you can write in these three areas. So let's write something in the left area. For instance, we are writing spreadsheet. Then in the center area, bring your pointer here to the center area, text box. And then we can type here anything that you like. We are typing computer shiksha. Then bring your pointer to the right area text box. Click there and type the text that you want. Watch in the video. Since we are right now doing class 7, we have typed class 7. You can type whatever you like, a title, your school name or date maybe, and then click on OK. Click on the main page box also, OK. Of course, you don't see it applied on your sheet, but if you take your pointer to the file menu and click on page preview, you will see that all these changes have been applied. As is being shown in the video, you have the three texts appearing, spreadsheet, computer shiksha, and class 7. So the header is there. Close preview. And let's take our pointer to the format option and see how to apply the footer. Again, go to the page option. From the box that opens, now click on the footer option. And in the footer again, make sure that the footer on has been ticked so that you can get the options for footer. Once again, come to the edit button, click there. Again, here also, you can type text for the left area, right area, and center area. So in the left area, we come to the text box, click there, and we type the date here. This is just as an example. So we are typing a date. Then in the center, you can type the page number, for instance. And in the right area, you can write any heading you like, your school name, maybe your name. Also, if you see below here, you can use predefined footers also. So we have just typed time just to fill that. And in the footer area, if you see in the bottom, you can select predefined footers also. So if you like, you can select from here. We have already typed something, so we just click on OK after selecting none. Click on OK on the page box also. Again, you don't see the changes applied to the sheet, but if you go to the file menu and click on the page preview, you will be able to see the changes applied. So you can see the footer has also come. The date is there, page number is there, and the word time we had written is also there. We are just zooming up and down to see the page clearly. Again, you can see the header has been applied, the footer has been applied, the background color has been changed. So this is how you can use the page option. We will now learn about the print range option. With print range, you can define a range for your selected data, such that when you print your sheet, it will get printed till the defined range only. With the help of the video, let us learn more about using the print range. Let us watch this video and learn the use of the print range option. With print range, you can select the range of the sheet or the area of the sheet that you want to print. So first, we need to know which area you want to print. Then take your pointer to the format menu, left click on that, and then bring your pointer to the print range option. You can see options for define, add, and edit are highlighted right now. So if you click on define, you can define the range of the sheet that you want to print. For instance, we are now going to select. Right now, where our cursor was, it is being defined. So we select these two columns, column A and column B. Then take a pointer to format, click on print range, and now we click on define. So this range has been defined. You can see very lines which are appearing on your sheet, but when you print, it will print only this area. Once again, taking to format, look at print range, and now if you click on add, what you can do is, you can add to the area that you had selected. So now we have selected the A, B, C, D columns till here. And we want to print this entire area. So we have selected this. So this will be, when we print, this area would be printed. You can see the light lines appearing around A, B, C, D. Once again, go to format, go to print range, and this time let's click on remove. If you click on remove, your defined area or the selected area is removed. So this is how you can use print range to tell CalC how much you want to print. Once again, we are going to format, and in the print range, we can go to edit. In edit, you have options. You can define the print range by clicking on the drop down here, and you can choose the entire sheet. You can choose a selection. Similarly, if you want to print some rows out of the sheet, you can select the rows, and you can also do the same with columns. So you can use this option also of the print range, the edit print range, to print what you like. So we just close this. This is how you can use the print range option of the format menu. Let us now learn about auto format. With auto format, you can put a style on the table that you have made. There are predefined styles available in auto format, and you can apply these. We will now learn about using the auto format with the help of the video. Let us now learn about applying auto format on our CalC sheet. With auto format, you can put a design or a style on your table. So for this, you first need to select the area of the table that you want to put the style on or the design on. Take your pointer to format. And you can see auto format is highlighted here. If you had not selected the table, or if you had not selected an area of the sheet, then if you take your pointer to auto to format, you will not get auto format highlighted. So you first must select the area of the table that you want to change or apply a new style on. Then take the pointer to format, left click there, and left click on auto format, a box opens and it shows you so many options which are already predefined. So different styles are there. You can scroll up and down. You have a 3D style, you have black one, black two, blue, brown. So there are many options available. You select one which you like. For instance, we have selected the brown one, and then we click on OK. This gets applied on your table. Now, if you want to change this once again, you need to remember that you have to select the area of the table that you want to apply the style or change the design. So, we will first select this table, take a pointer to format, left click on that, and then click on auto format. Select another design which you like. We can select default and click on OK, and the default design is there. Once again, if you want to change, once again click on auto format, look at various designs which are available and change. So this is how you can use the auto format option of the format menu. Next is the option for conditional formatting. As you can make out from the name itself, with conditional formatting, you can apply conditions and do the formatting. Learn more about using conditional formatting by watching the video. In this video, we will see how we can apply conditional formatting on our sheet. With conditional formatting, we can apply formatting through conditions on any row or any column. So to do that, we first need to take a pointer to the format menu in the menu bar, left click on that, and then click on conditional formatting option. However, if we click on conditional formatting without selecting from the table, we will not be able to apply. So let's close this window first and then first select the area where we want to apply conditional formatting. So we've just selected the second row. Take your pointer to format option, left click on it, left click on the conditional formatting option here. Now from the box, the first value that you can apply is if the cell value is, and then you can apply a condition. Click on this drop down box and we have applied greater than. You can apply less than, equal to, whatever condition. We have applied if the cell value is greater than 150 in this row, then we are saying let the cell style get changed to default to, and by opening this box cell style, we can now change the font effects. So we can apply a different font color. So whenever the value of the cell is in that row is greater than 150, we are now saying we can change the border, we can change the border color. So we say OK here and we say OK to this box also. Click on OK and you can see that in the second row that we had selected, because 158 is more than 150, its color got changed and also a border got applied on this. Now let's select the second row and apply conditional formatting by taking a pointer to the format option of the menu bar, click on conditional formatting. This time in the box, let's use if the cell value is less than. So we are saying if the cell value is less than 90, then apply a condition and we'll click on the new style button here. The box opens and we are going to change the font effects. We are going to change the font color. So we are asking that if the condition is met, if any of the cell values is less than 90, change the font color to blue, because we have selected blue here. Then we can also change the size and the typeface. So we are making it bold and we are making it 14 size. We click OK. We click OK on this box also. And you can see that wherever the condition is met in this row, because 70 is less than 90, so it gets highlighted and the typeface has changed. Also, the color has changed. and it has become bold also. Now you will revise the formulas from the last class. First of all, go ahead and apply the conditions for pass and fail, and if you have any doubts, then learn by watching the video. With the help of this video, we are just going to practice applying the if formula, which we have already learned. So to apply the if formula, let's use the E column where the result is written, and in the E2, we are applying the formula for if. So we have to type equal to if, then start bracket, which is shift 9, and then you have to put the value which you want to test. So we select the value of the total, we select from there, which is D2, and then we apply the condition that if D2 is greater than, and we are saying 160. After that we put a semicolon and then we put our statement. If this is true, then it should say select. So we put select in inverted commas as is shown in the video. And once again we put a semicolon. And if it is not true, then it should say reject. So we write reject also in inverted commas. Then we have to close the bracket, which is shift and 0. After closing, we can just press enter and you will see that it will show reject because the total, which is 158 for A row, is less than 160. You can see here, once again, if you click on where we had typed the formula, you can see that D2 should be greater than 160 for select. Otherwise, it will show reject, which it is showing a reject right now because the total is only 158. Now, we can, as you know, we can just drag the formula which we applied by clicking on the black dot here. When the plus sign appears, just drag it down and you will see all the answers being shown for the if formula. Wherever there's only 167 at the end, which is more than 160, so that shows a select, the others show reject. This is how you can use the if formula. Next, practice the use of the AND formula in the second column. If you face a problem, watch the video to learn more. You will now practice the AND formula. So first, for the AND formula, remember that if two conditions are given and if both are true, then the answer will be true. Even if one condition is false, the answer will be false. So first we are selecting D column to practice AND. So in the title we write AND, and in D2 cell we have to write the formula for AND, which you know is equal to AND AND. Then start the bracket by pressing shift and 9 key. Then we have to give the first condition or the logical value. So we have selected the B2 value. And the condition we are giving is if B2 is equal to Y. Remember, you have to write Y in inverted commas. So we are writing that. Then we have to put a semicolon. You must remember to use all of these. We are selecting the second value as C2, and now for this we are putting a condition if C2 is also equal to, let's put Y. So we put Y in inverted commas and close the bracket and press enter. Now if both the statements are true, it will give true. Even if one statement is false, as you can see, it says false. Because if you look at this formula here, B2 is equal to Y, and that is correct. B2 was Y, but C2 is equal to Y is not correct because C2 is N. So when we apply this formula and if one of the statements is false, it returns false as the answer. In the next cell, D3 cell, let's again use the formula for practice. Equal to AND, begin bracket, then select the first value and apply the condition. So we are saying B3 and we are saying equal to, again we have to put inverted commas and type Y and close the inverted commas. And after that, remember to put the semicolon. As is being shown in the video to you, put the semicolon here and then apply the second condition for the second statement. So we select C3 now and we say if this is also equal to Y. So again we write C3, we put the equal to sign, inverted comma start, then type Y, then inverted comma close. Remember to use the format correctly. Then close the bracket by using shift and 0. And when you press enter, you will find that this answer is true. Because here both the values, both the conditions are true. B3 is actually Y, C3 is also Y. So both are correct. So the answer that we get on pressing enter is true. As you can see here. Now we can just apply the same formula by dragging it. So we click on the true form where we had applied the formula. Click on the button, the black button. When the plus sign comes, we drag it down. So you can see the third C column shows false because none of them is true. Both the statements are NN, but the fourth one, D column, is YY. So this way we can use the AND formula. Now practice the use of the OR formula. Watch the video to learn more. Let us now practice the use of the OR formula. So to apply OR in the E column, we want to type the title OR OR. Remember, in OR, if either of the two statements is true, the answer will be true. So even if one statement is true, you will get answer as true. So in the next cell, which is F2, E2, we type the formula for OR, which is equal to. So we type equal to and then we type OR, OR, and then begin the bracket with shift and 9 key. And then we have to type the logical value, first logical value, or apply the first condition. So we have selected the B2 cell and we are saying equal to, then begin inverted commas and type Y. So we are saying if B2 is equal to Y, or, and then we close the inverted commas and then remember to put a semicolon. Now we have to apply the second condition. So select the second value, which is of C2. So this time again we are saying C2 equal to Y. So we type C2 by selecting and type equal to, then the inverted comma begins, Y, inverted comma close and bracket close. Remember to do all of this, and then when you press enter, you will find the answer as true. You can see here in E2, the formula that we have applied, it says B2 equal to Y. So the first condition is right because B2 is actually Y. But C2 is not equal to Y because it is N. However, since one of the statements is true, the answer for OR formula will be true. Now we can drag down this formula from E2 cell by clicking on the dot here and drag it down. And you will find that the answer this time again is true. Because you can see here both the statements are true. In the next one, let us see what happens. Both the answers are N and N. So we type equal to OR, then we select, After first opening the bracket, we select B4 and then we say equal to, and within inverted commas we type Y, put a semicolon, then select C4 as the second condition, for the second condition, and again we say C4 equal to, within inverted commas we type Y. So we are again saying the same condition, that, and close the bracket. Press enter. Now the answer will be false, because both the statements are false. If you see here, the formula was, if B4 is equal to Y, this is not true. Or if C4 is equal to Y, this is also not true. So both are not true. So in the OR statement, when both the statements are not true, the answer is false. Now we can just drag the same formula down here. Since both the statements are correct, Y, so the answer will be Y. This is how you can use the OR formula on your sheet. Next, go ahead and practice the use of count and count blank formulas. In case of problems, learn with the help of the video. Let us now practice the use of the count and count blank formula. So the count formula helps you to count the number of cells where you have done some work. Let us first select sheet 1 so that we can use that sheet and use the count formula in this sheet. So since we want to use the count formula in the F column, so in the F1 cell, we just type count as the title, C-O-U-N-T. As is being shown in the video to you. And then in the next cell, F2, we have to type the formula. You have to type an equal to sign. Then for the count formula, you have to type C-O-U-N-T. Begin the bracket by pressing shift and the 9 key together. And then it says first value, second value, so on. So you have to select the values where you want to count this. So we are selecting this area and then we close the bracket. As soon as we close the bracket and press enter, it gives you a count. So the cells that you have done some work on are shown here. Now, if you want to use count blank will show you in the range that you select from your table, where you have not done any work, it will count those cells. So to do that, we first come to the G column, and in the G1 cell, let's type the title count blank. Remember, count counts the cells where you have done some work, whereas count blank counts the blank cells in the area that you select from the table. Now in the G2 cell, we need to type the formula for count blank, which is equal to, and then the word count blank, C-O-U-N-T-B-L-A-N-K. So type that full thing, full word, count blank, then begin bracket by pressing shift and the 9 key together. Then we need to select the range from the table. So we are selecting this entire range from the A1 cell to F5 cell. And close the bracket, press enter, and you can see the answer is 3. Because in the F column, there are these 3 cells which are blank. You can see these. So count blank is giving you the answer as 3. For these 3 blank cells. Today's class ends here. Save your file and then shut down your computers properly. Today, you learned about some of the options of the format Meno, like cells, rows, columns, sheet, merge cells, page, print area, auto format and conditional formatting. And then you practice the formulas for if, and, or, count and count blank.
Computer Shiksha is supported by.
Thank you.